Hello, my name is Mike Parker, and I'm the Tree Fruit Extension Specialist at North Carolina State University. Today, we're in the Apple Research Orchard at the Mountain Horticultural Crops Research Station in Mills River. Today, we'd like to discuss apple rootstocks and their performance in North Carolina. The orchard we are in today is a gala orchard and is part of the NC-140 Regional Rootstock Research Project. The NC-140 is a group of my colleagues from across the country where we evaluate rootstocks on a wide range of multiple locations, multiple varieties, and multiple systems. Apple trees are budded or grafted onto apple rootstocks. As you know, apple trees, when planted from seed, do not come true. And when we plant an orchard, we want the orchard to be of a specific variety. So in addition to having trees that come true to seed and true to variety, we also select rootstocks based upon their ability to tolerate the climate, whether it be cold or heat. We also select rootstocks that are tolerant to insects and diseases that are of specific concern in the environment they're being planted. The major issue that we look at apple rootstocks is also for size control. Do you want to have trees that are very large, take a long time to come into bearing, or would you be looking at size controlling rootstocks or dwarfing rootstocks, where all the work can be done from the ground and they're highly efficient rootstocks? The tree I'm sitting next to right now is at M7. It's a large semi-dwarfing apple rootstocks, and as you can notice, the work needs to be done from ladders, which can be time-consuming and also can result in issues with worker safety. Today, I would like to talk about several of the rootstocks that we are looking at in North Carolina that are very promising and have commercial potential. When looking at apple rootstocks, you'll notice that there is a letter followed by a number. Those letters may be M or MM, Malling or Malling Merton, coming from England. There are also a series of rootstocks coming from Russia, and they're called Budagovsky Bud, or just abbreviated to B. There's also a series of rootstocks abbreviated CG or G that is referring to Geneva. This is a series of rootstocks that were developed at Cornell in New York. The rootstock we are standing next to now is a Bud 9. Bud 9s produce a tree that is approximately 35 to 40% of a full-size tree. It is utilized primarily because of its field resistance to the fire blight bacterium. In North Carolina, the size of a Bud 9 is seriously affected by the amount of the rootstock shank that we leave out of the ground. The greater the length of the rootstock out of the ground, the greater the dwarfing will be. As we said, Bud 9 is used because of its field resistance to the fire blight bacterium. Conversely, if we look at a rootstock that is used primarily the M26, it is very susceptible to fire blight bacterium. This tree was lost last year because of fire blight infection. The rootstock we are standing next to now is M9 NAKBT337, or just abbreviated M9337. This rootstock is the primary rootstock plant in the United States as a dwarfing rootstock. The characteristics, we have a tree here that goes up to a supported height of 8 foot, which our stake you can see goes up to 8 foot. The ultimate height of this tree will be held to approximately 10 foot in this orchard. Another selection of M9 is called M9 Pajam 2. This is an M9 Pajam 2 here. It is a more vigorous tree than the M9337. You can notice that by the fullness of the canopy that it fills in.
But both the M9 and M9337 rootstocks provide growth control that results in a tree that is approximately 30 to 35% of a full-size tree.
Another promising rootstock in our evaluations is G41. G41 produces a tree approximately the size of an M9. It is very resistant to fire blight. It is also tolerant to replant disorders. Another rootstock in our evaluations is G11. G11 produces a tree approximately the size of an M9. It is resistant to fire blight. However, it is not resistant to replant disorders. Another promising rootstock in our dwarf evaluations is G16. G16 is resistant to fire blight and is partially tolerant to replant disorders. One of the most promising rootstocks in our dwarf evaluations is a G935. G935 produces a tree that is a little smaller than an M26. It performs very well in replant sites. It's also very resistant to fire blight. It is also very precocious or bears fruit very early. In most of our research trials, G935 has been the most productive rootstock after the fourth year. One of the largest dwarfing rootstocks that we're evaluating is M26. M26 produces a tree that's approximately 55 to 60% of a full-size tree. One of the shortcomings with M26 is its susceptibility to fire blight, especially when we're planting fire blight-sensitive varieties such as Fusia or Pink Lady, which make M26 not the best choice in those situations. Another promising rootstock in our evaluation for the semi-dwarf trees is a G30. A G30 produces a tree approximately 65% of a full-size tree. G30 performs very well in replant sites. However, there's some nursery production issues at this point in time that may limit its commercial availability. Another semi-dwarfing rootstock is a G210. G210 produces a tree that's approximately 60 to 65% of a full-size tree. It is also very resistant to fire blight and to replant disorders. When evaluating semi-dwarf rootstocks, many growers still prefer M7 rootstocks because they do not require an extensive support system. In North Carolina, M7 is the most predominant semi-dwarfing rootstock planted. However, we have found in replant sites it performs very poorly and is not recommended in those situations. This is an M7 tree. We plant those approximately a 10 by 20 spacing within the orchard. We do not expect significant production until at least year 5. We've just looked at 9-year-old gala trees and the rootstock performance up to this point in time. However, this is ongoing research, and behind me you'll see a planting of 4-year-old Aztec Fujis. This is also part of the NC-140 project and is planted across the country. This is ongoing research from the College of Agriculture and Life Science at North Carolina State University. The goal of this research is to help the growers in North Carolina to be profitable and productive and sustainable in their orchard operations. For more information on apple rootstock that may be suitable to your site, visit the eExtension site and look for our apple rootstocks. We developed the eExtension site from the research-based information generated from the NC-140 Regional Research Group. This information is provided to assist all of the apple growers in the United States to help their operations be much more productive and profitable.